Hi everyone, it's Amy from thecrazycraftlady.com. If you're new around here, I love, love, love making super easy, budget-friendly crafts and DIY home decor projects, and today is no different. I'm back with two new dollar store crafts. I love shopping at my Dollar Tree for seasonal decor items and craft supplies, but their kitchen section is also a wealth of creativity and resources for making some home decor projects. Today, I'm gonna use a pizza pan and a cookie tray to make some super cute farmhouse style home decor. So let's get making. I started with a baking sheet and a pizza pan. Both came from my local Dollar Tree. First, I drilled four holes into the pizza pan, two on each end. I started with my smallest drill bit and worked my way up to the largest one I had in my set. Then I took white spray primer and painted both pans. It works best to use thin coats, and it will probably take 2 to 3 coats to get all of the metal covered on the trays. Once the spray paint has dried, you can start crafting with your dollar store trays. I started with a baking sheet. I wanted to make a cute little decorative tray, so I grabbed these craft sticks from the dollar store. They're just wide popsicle sticks. The wood is thin enough that you can actually cut them with a regular pair of scissors, so I just cut off the rounded ends with my scissors. Then I set them in place on the tray to make sure that they were the right size and that they would all fit. Be sure to cut the craft sticks at varying lengths and stagger them so that you kind of have that shiplap or planked look. To cover this tray, you will need probably 2/3 of the packet of craft sticks. I just use regular old Rust-Oleum chalk paint, but you can use really whatever white paint you have on hand. Then I used a wide paintbrush to paint the craft sticks. I used a dry brush technique so that I didn't have complete coverage on the sticks. They look a little bit weathered or distressed, and you can still see a bit of the wood grain poke through. The nice thing about using chalk paint is that it dries quickly. I was able to hot glue all of my craft sticks in place soon after painting them. Finally, I used this nautical rope that comes in the craft section at the Dollar Tree to make handles for my tray. I just threaded a section of rope through each hole on the end of the tray and secured it with a knot in the back. Just be careful because it takes more length than you would think to tie a knot in the rope. I ended up having to throw away my first cut of rope because it was too short. You can always retie the knot and make the handle shorter, but you can't make it longer. So for about $3 worth of craft supplies, I was able to make a cute little decorative serving tray. Next up was time to get creative with this pizza pan. Just like the cookie sheet, I gave the pizza pan a coat with spray primer. The dollar store has a section of really cute placemats, and some of them have fun sayings on them, so I grabbed this placemat that says, "Our nest is best." I traced the pizza pan onto the back of the placemat, and then I cut the placemat down to size. Then I simply secured the placemat to the pizza pan using hot glue. Then I grabbed more of that nautical rope from the dollar store and I used that to cover the seam between the edge of the cut placemat and the pizza pan. Be sure to use plenty of hot glue and make sure the seam between rope ends is at the bottom of the door hanger. This way it can be covered up later. Then I grabbed a small sprig of lamb's ear that I purchased at Walmart. I cut off all the ends and made a little bunch with leaves on either end. Then I grabbed some dollar store burlap ribbon to secure all of the stems together with hot glue. To make a bow, I just form a ribbon into a figure eight, and then I secured the center of the bow with a small piece of ribbon and hot glue. After attaching the leaves and ribbon to the door hanger, I also added a hanger with nautical rope and hot glue. So with a few dollars worth of supplies, I had a cute little door or wall hanger. So that's it, two farmhouse style DIY decor crafts. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Until next time, happy making.